In 2018, for the first time on record, the 400 richest Americans paid a lower effective tax rate than the bottom half.
Stop. Go back to that graph. Sorry.
Yeah.
Now you'll notice what he did here in this graph in the bottom right-hand corner, what his source is. The source is the Washington Post, and it's the Saez and Zuckman
economists that did that study.
Now, Robert Reich is using a research study that is bogus to begin with.
And the Washington Post article says why it's wrong in the Washington Post article.
Yes.
Where they posted this, and he's citing the Washington Post on the graph. And I know what you're thinking. Well, did you bring in a cut from the Washington Post article for me to read, Nate? Well, yes, I did, Charlie.
I sure did.
It's right there. Do the rich pay lower taxes? I did bring in the part of that article.
For the first time in U.S. history, U.S. billionaires paid a lower tax rate than the working class last year. This was big news. Remember when this came out? Everybody, they're still obviously touting this to today, okay? On the question of tax burden, Jason Furman, an economics professor at Harvard University who chaired the White House Council of Economic Advisors under President Barack Obama, noted that Saez and Zuckman did not include the refundable tax credits, such as the earned income tax credit, in their analysis. The credit, which is intended to encourage low-income families to work, is part of the tax code, Furman said. A person who paid $1,000 in federal income taxes and then received a $1,500 credit would have a total federal tax burden of negative $500, meaning $500 would go in your pocket, okay? But Furman said that under Saez and Zuckman's analysis, that person would instead show a burden of $0. That result would make the total tax burdens at the lower end of the income spectrum appear higher than they are. So yeah. What they did is anybody who had a negative, which means you received more money from the government than you paid in, they just defaulted all those people to zero as if they didn't pay taxes and not counting the negative number. What that does is that skews the effective tax rate of the bottom 50% because you're getting rid of all the negative ones. And so that's how they're using this graph. And then they just spit this out as it's truth. And this is so maddening that this is still used today.
They just cite it. Like it's a real thing. Just cite it. Just talk about it. Just say it.
It's absolutely mind boggling, especially somebody who is, and this is why, you know, it's an agenda, right? It has nothing to do with the actual truth, because if he was an economist worth his salt, then he would never use a study like this and he wouldn't put this false information together. So this right here, regardless of the first minute we saw anyway, including this graph and this source and saying this completely disregards the whole thing. You can't believe a word this guy says.
Because they're building everything off of this premise in the first place, by the way, that the rich pay a lower effective tax rate than the people in the bottom, than the working class, because rich people don't work. That's what we also know about people who have a lot of money, is that they don't work. And by the way, there was another thing in here when we were talking about the top 1% paying 40% of the taxes. I found a fact check on that because people, these right-wing extremists have been using this 40% number, this top 1% pay 40% of the taxes. And I found an article from New York Magazine called "No, the Richest 1% Don't Pay 40% of the Taxes." It's great. Actually, one of the sad constants of American political debate is that any time the tax rate on the rich is to be either raised or lowered, Republicans will repeat a certain statistic. The stat is that the highest earning 1% of taxpayers pay 40% of all income taxes.
Of all. Yeah. All of them.
In the thing that says, no, they don't do this, here's another paragraph. The stat is literally true. Start a paragraph with that. The stat is...
Three paragraphs into the fact check.
Literally true. But it is deeply misleading.
Now, what about their headline? Is the headline misleading? No, the richest 1% don't pay 40% of the taxes. But three paragraphs into that, the headline, it says the stat is literally true. Well, they actually do. But let me tell you why it's wrong.
Yeah.
So Nate and I have come up with a solution to this, which is we are starting the fact checker of the fact checkers. We're going to start fact checking the fact checkers.
I think that would be a worthwhile thing to do.
Well, you're welcome.
They continue this conversation about paying your fair share. The rich need to pay their fair share, finally. And what they consistently what they try to do is they say that, well, they're not paying their share of what the income is. You know, they make all this income and they're not paying what the fair share is. Now, this person who also wrote this, did this article, put out this graph. And once they take into account all of the other taxes that people pay, because remember, the stat is the income taxes. The top 1% pay 40% of all the income taxes. And they say that is literally true. All right. And so they also bring in this graph right here and they say, no, that's not true. And so for the top 1%, here's the total income. The total share of income is 20.9%. And they pay 24.1% of all of the taxes, meaning they still pay more than what the share of income is. Now, that's still, how is that not your fair share? I still want to know the answer to that question. You're paying more because when you go to the poorest 20%, well, they're paying a lower percentage than what their income is. You go to the second 20%, they're paying a lower percentage than what their income is. The middle 20%, they're paying a lower percentage than what their income is. The fourth 20%, they're paying a lower percentage than what their income is. And then you get into like the middle class, upper middle class, and they're the first bracket that starts paying a little bit more than what their income is, 26.1% to 25.5%. And so what I want to know is, what do you mean by fair share? Like, what's fair? You're paying more than what your percentage of the income is. So what are you talking about here? I don't quite get it. I don't quite get the argument here. Oh, let's go into some more fallacies real quick.
Lower effective tax rate than the bottom half. Repealing the Trump tax cuts benefits to the wealthy and big corporations will raise an estimated $500 billion over a decade.
Now stop.
$500 billion over a decade.
Because I've been told repeatedly, the number that is cited is that the Trump tax cuts cost us $1.2 trillion over a decade. All right, that's the number. I've seen Robert Reich throw that number out there a bunch of times. Robert Reich III, sorry, I want to get it right. I want to get it right. Now he's saying that reinstituting those would bring in $500 billion over 10 years. That's, I don't know, I just find that weird.
Decade